oh my god, it's a beautiful piece of paper. I love it. I
mean, it's a back lady, darling.
It looks amazing, but I can't.
So I do it till you do it.
Oh, you're doing it. It's like a reveal.
I do it till you do it.
No, you do it. I gotta see it.
1, 2, 3.
My name is Selby Drummond, and I'm getting married on June 1st.
Stephen proposed in August in Amagansett. We were hanging out just at our house in Long Island. Stephen, at one point at about 4 o'clock, we were watching TV and he said he was going upstairs to put his Invisalign in. And he came back downstairs and he had this red little note in his hand and he shoved this note at me. And he just looked at me and he said, I'm leaving now. I'm sending you on a scavenger hunt. Don't ask any questions. Don't call me unless you really need something. At that point, to be honest, I realized I thought I knew what was going on. This was more elaborate than anything he'd ever done, and I had a feeling. So I drove myself to Montauk. At that point, had started sort of crying and shaking. I was going like 85 miles an hour. I had the windshield wipers going and it wasn't raining. I had the side view mirrors tucked in on the truck, and the back flap of the pickup truck was like flapping in the wind. It was the best proposal I ever could have imagined. If I had dreamt something up in my head, it wouldn't have been better. I've always had this wondered why when men propose, women are just supposed to all of a sudden say, yes, I've been waiting, no questions asked, I don't need to think about it. And I loved that I had like basically an hour and a half to myself to really think about this, to really let it sink in and think, no, this is what I really want. I've been here for 4 years and I'm really excited. I got back to the house in Amagansett. There was actually a rainbow. I walked into the backyard and he was sitting there. He had flowers and he took the ring and said, wait, I want to do the thing, and got down on one knee, said something beautiful. I can't remember what he said. He can't remember what he said. It was a lot happening at the moment, and asked me to marry him. And I said yes. And I'm here in Paris doing my final wedding dress fitting with Giambattista Valli. I've worn his dresses before. I wore one of his gowns to the Met Gala last year, and it was the best I've ever felt. And people told me it was the best I'd ever looked. And I kind of feel like I knew at that moment that when I was going to get married, I would at least want to ask him. I didn't know what would happen, but I wanted to ask if he would at least consider sharing something with me. I met Giambattista at a party in Positano out at night, and we had an amazing night and time together, and it feels really perfect that I'm wearing one of his dresses to my wedding, because I think that energy of like, it's about fun, it's about joy, it's about spontaneity, it's about having fun in an authentic way, and that's where I met him, that's where I found him.
We connected in life. I mean, we connected one day, we connected out of the blue, and then we never disconnected. It's funny because I always do wedding dresses like in a different way of other people do. I would do wedding dresses as a party dress, so I don't really care about the thing that it's a wedding dress. I just want to, you know, it's an happy moment that let's party all together. A wedding dress, and there's always something cast to me, or there is always something like dusty or something conventional, and I always broke at this idea, because you know, you can see all the dresses that I did it. I mean, they're always like kind of party dresses.
So we started with a dress from his most recent couture runway, and we had some conversations about it, and I came in and tried that dress on, and we talked about what we would want to fit.
So she just came with the pictures from a show that she was sitting front row, and she was saying, I wanted this, that's it.
And so he sent me a sketch after that, so we could make sure we were kind of all on the same page, and I was understanding what his vision was. I tried on that original dress, and we really talked through all the details. We talked about the sleeves, we pinned a little bit, we pulled out, it was originally short in the front, so we pulled some spare lace and draped it in the front so we could see what it would be like long. So it was really working with the other dress to imagine some ideas and infer what the final result would be, but this was the first time I actually put on the dress itself.
Okay, do I step in? Can I take my clothes off?
The best, because you know
I'm
what?
I'm like extremely not shy, so I don't care. So I should go. You just tell me what to do.
I love it. Me either.
But it's beautiful. I mean, it's insane.
Idea.
Allora. I think that my design, they keep it spontaneous, the movement of a woman. They keep it spontaneous, the personality of a woman. You know, I always say that I do 50% of the job. 50% is the woman wearing it, interpreting it. In my philosophy, I think it's very important to be extremely supportive to the final real woman.
My one thing about this is that
I liked it. I think I sent, but I liked the
you
original.
You wanted more V?
Yeah.
Look, I showed you.
Yeah.
Look, this is, we just put it in case, so.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah, it was everything
it
is.
This
is the magic of haute couture.
You
can
you just take it out?
Yes.
But the question was just if we have less
we can
ruffles
have
here.
Yeah, but you want it less here?
Yeah, so let me just see if I can like fake it.
I think not too much. I think it's nice if you can see like the shape, the waist. So it's nice to see here and to see here. She has a very superhero body. I mean, you look at her, she's like a blonde version of Wonder Woman. Like, she's very tall, so with the kind of proportion that I put in the dress, she looks like a little bit more human proportion, that, you know, like more fragile. So it's something that you redesign around the silhouette.
It's beautiful.
It's amazing. That's really, on the shape and everything.
Well, the back
is too much.
Perfect.
And it's a perfection, really. And the front look has to be here, less heavy, just to give it like, you know, beautiful shape of your body. But I think this is so beautiful. And remember, the front is extremely important, but in the weddings, the back is even more important than the front. You always remember like weddings from the back. I mean, I love to make them people happy. I feel happy. This is my biggest happiness. So there is nothing better to share like happy moments, like for example, the wedding or other amazing moments. You know, I would work around beauty and love stories. So this is like a perfection.
Friendship, laughter, peace, and love. And may the rejoicing of this day resound throughout all the days of your life together. What the bonds of love have joined, let no one break asunder. Stephen and Selby, you have consented freely to join together in matrimony. You have pledged each other vows, declaring your commitment before friends and family. You have affirmed this commitment by the giving and receiving of rings. I now pronounce you husband and wife.